ஹலோ ஸ்டூடெண்ட், வெல்கம் பேக். நவ் த லாஸ்ட் செஷன் ஆர் லாஸ்ட் கான்செப்ட் இன் திஸ் மாடியூல் 4 இஸ் ஜேஎஸ்எம் அண்ட் ஆஃப் வித் காமன் எம்எஸ்சி. நவ் வாட் இஸ் அண்ட் ஆஃப்? அண்ட் ஆஃப் அக்கர்ஸ் வென் மொபைல் ஸ்டேஷன் சேஞ்ச் இட்ஸ் அசோசியேஷன் ஃப்ரம் ஒன் பேஸ் ஸ்டேஷன் டு அனதர் டியூரிங் த கால். தட் மீன்ஸ் வென் த மொபைல் ஸ்டேஷன் மூவ்ஸ் ஃப்ரம் ஒன் பேஸ் ஸ்டேஷன் டு தி அதர் பேஸ் ஸ்டேஷன்ஸ், தென் த கால் ஹேஸ் டு பி அண்டர்வர்ட் ப்ராப்பர்லி without disturbing the ongoing conversation between with the mobile user. So this is called as and off. In the diagram you can see here, suppose I will take, this is the old BSS base service station, then this is the new BSS new BSS. Now both are coming under same mobile switching center. Now here the and off is not a big deal or big problem, but there are several steps involved. Now reason for and off is a stronger signal to from new BSS. That is, as soon as the user moves away from the BSS, the link between the mobile and the BSS will get weakened. In that case, it is necessary to transfer that user from one this BSS to the other BSS. And sometimes when so many users are in one BSS, then that will load the particular BSS. So what is required here? This is a load balance. Load balance is required. So to free up the channel. And third one is GSM doesn't mandate why to perform and off policy, only our mechanism. So and off is initiated by the old BSS. Now we'll see how this exactly works. There are several steps. In the exam, you need to write this step, and it is here clearly mentioned or clearly given how the step works. Let me explain. Now, our mobile user moving from this old BSS to the new BSS. What is the step? Old BSS informs MSC. MSC means this mobile switching center of impending and off. Provides list of 1+ new BSS. That is, it will inform the mobile switching center about the new BSS. MSC now set up path and allocate resource to the new BSS. Now new BSS allocate radio channel and it will inform our MSC. New BSS signal MSC, old BSS inform old BSS that it is ready. Old BSS now tells the mobile. That doesn't mean that mobile user will come to know. No, that will tell the mobile for the and off to new BSS. Now the mobile will get connected to the new BSS and signal activating and new channel will be done. Now the mobile signal is routed to new BSS to MSC and off is complete. MSC reroutes the call. Now MSC old BSS resources released. These are the different steps required here. So in the exam you need to write and off with the common MSC. So it's very simple. First, it will inform MSC. MSC will allocate resource. After this resource is done, it will allocate our BSS allocate signals, and it will tell the it will allocate signals, radio channels. Then from there, our mobile switching center and center will inform the old BSS. That is, things are ready. Then old BSS inform the mobile. Now mobile will switch over from old BSS to the new BSS, and the new BSS signals are activated and calls are routed to the through new BSS to the mobile. So this is the process. Now you see in the diagram here, earlier diagram there was only one MSC. Both these BSS are coming under the same mobile switching center, but in this case you can see our mobile user is moving from one MSC to the other MSC. So it keeps on changing the MSC. That time how the and off will be handled when our mobile user and off between MSCs. So here we have one more term that is called as anchor MSC. This is anchor MSC. This is the anchor MSC. Understood? So So the first embassy visited by our mobile user is the anchor embassy, which remains as the anchor embassy. Now the calls are routed through anchor embassy irrespective of number of embassies switched over by our mobile user. So you can see here new embassy add on to the end of the embassy chain as mobile moves to the new embassy, and also there are optional path minimization steps also taken care. Finally, at the end, our correspondent and home embassy and anchor embassy will be there in the picture when our mobile user move from between different embassies, and handoff will be taken like this. Now next, last concept here, my dear students, last concept here. You have to compare GSM versus mobile IP. Comparison is given here. GSM element, comment on GSM element and particular mobile IP element. So I have explained all these things. Just you have to go through the comparison. What are the different GSM element here? For example, home system, gateway mobile switching center, home MSC, visited system, visited mobile service switching center, VLR, all these are explained. And particular this one, terminology in the mobile IP element, what is it is called as mobile IP element? You need to compare it and you need to read it. So next one is the last concept here. How the mobility impact on higher layer protocols. We know higher layer protocols, TCP and UDP, normally higher layer protocols, right? Transport layer. When the user moves from one end to the other end, as the mobility increases, how this will affect the higher layer protocols. It says here, TCP and UDP also run over wireless or mobile network, but the performance-wise, there is a packet loss, delay due to bit errors, discarded packets, delays for the link layer transmission, retransmission, and handoff, and TCP here intercepts losses as a congestion, and it will decrease the congestion window unnecessarily. And there is a delay for real-time traffic, traffic for voice and video, and limited bandwidth of the wireless link also one more disadvantage. Limited bandwidth of the wireless link also one more disadvantage. It is not a wired network, it is a wireless network. All these will affect our higher layer protocols. So wireless effect, wireless and mobility impact on higher layer protocols. So this is summarize the higher layer protocols. With this student, I have completed the fourth module. So now you have to go through the fourth module. Now you have to go through all these videos, and if you have any doubt, come back to me so that we'll try to solve your doubt. Thank you.